I want to thank you for giving me a few moments just to come into your home on this Christmas Eve and to share with your family. Over the next 3 days, I will be presenting to you devotionals online. And at the end of each of these, I will give a challenge to you and your family during this Christmas season. On this first day, I wanted to tell you a story about an aunt that I have, probably similar to someone that you have in your family. Every year, my aunt would come in to our family Christmas party, and she would bring a big stack of gifts for all the kids. And every year, it was the same thing as all of us kids, my brothers and my sisters and my cousins would sit around, and we would open these gifts from my aunt. We would always open them, and they would be something like underwear or tube socks. Not necessarily the gift a 7 or 8 year old kid is looking for. I was looking for Transformers or something, and I'm looking at a pair of tube socks with the big red and yellow rings around the top of them. And me and my cousins and my brothers and my sisters, we came up with this little saying that was, oh, just what we always wanted when we would open our aunt's gift. Well, the reality is it wasn't what we had always wanted. It was just our way of having a little fun with the moment. And our parents would often remind us, your aunt isn't getting you what you want. She's getting you what she thinks you need. You know, I think the same is true with the Christmas story. 2,000 years ago on that first Christmas, the Jews had been waiting for a Messiah. But they were wanting and they were expecting a Messiah that would come like a strong Jewish general who would help them to overthrow the tyranny of the Roman Empire. But in Matthew's gospel, they got something totally different. In verse 21 of Matthew 1, it says, "She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save their people from their sins." They were looking for freedom from oppression. But God gave them, through His Son, Jesus Christ, freedom from their sins. You see, on that first Christmas 2,000 years ago, it really wasn't about us getting what we wanted, but God definitely gave us what we so desperately needed. Today, on this Christmas Eve, I want to challenge you to celebrate that gift that Christmas is all about, the gift of God's salvation through His Son, Jesus Christ. My challenge to you on this Christmas Eve is to take the emblems of communion that you've been given over the last couple of services that we've had at Music City, and to now to take them and to share in Christmas Eve communion with your family. If you have extended family, invite them to be a part of it as well. But celebrate the gift that might have not been what people were wanting in that day, but is what we have all needed in God's salvation.